So we are here to learn something about you. What exactly the React is and why we have to learn React and in what way it is going to help us in web development. So those aspects we are going to learn now. So before I jump into React, I would like to we can call it as React.js or we can simply call it as React. Both are fine. Okay. So before I jump into particular things related to React, I would like to talk a little about how a web application structure will be. A typical web application structure will be in this world, web world, I can say. So that is, if you're talking about any typical web application here, it will be having a three-tier architecture. Usually it will be following a three-tier architecture here. So which assume like these blocks represent some tiers here. The first one is called presentation layer, and the second one is called business layer, or we call it as application layer. Both are same. Next comes your persistence layer, or we call it as data layer or database layer. It could be anything. So the purpose of this is to store the data permanently. For that purpose, we'll be using this data layer or database layer. Okay, fine. So when we are talking about this presentation layer, whenever we open any web application in this world, so for example, say like Gmail or whatever it is, the moment we'll be opening that through our client machine. Client machine means which are the computer or tablet or mobile we use, that could be called as a client machine. Whereas this will be connected to a centralized server machine will be there somewhere else, which is located at, assume like if you're talking about Gmail, maybe at some Google office, somewhere else it is located. But through different client machines will be connecting to that one. So how it is possible is because some website is already designed. So at the back end, it will be connected to some server. Okay, fine. When you're talking about that presentation layer here, everyone usually through any of the client, they'll be opening the browser, and in that opening that a particular address of that particular website will be typed in. That the moment it is done, then it will be connected to the server at the back end. So when we open that, like login page or something like sign up page or something like some home page, or in that dashboard page, something like different things. If you are using one kind of application, it will have one some kind of pages. But if you're using some other kind of application, it may have some other kind of pages. But the different pages will be there that we can able to see as a user, so that all such things will be represented in this presentation layer. In another words, I can say this presentation layer is responsible for the appearance of your web page here. So, and through this only, people are able to connect to our entire application here. So when it comes to this business layer or the main application layer, where the actual server related information will be written here, our server side code, I can say here, that will be written inside this business layer or application layer. So in this assume like some what I can some modular structure will be there, a modular code will be there, that is like to do different activities, you'll be having different modules. So for example, to do login activity, one module will be there which take cares of the login activity, and to do registration, one module will be there, and to purchase, assume like you're doing some e-commerce related application, where to do purchase related activity, we may have something like some article for purchase related thing. So like that, we can have something different things here. These are like some modules which can be developed with the help of any of the server side technology. So to develop the server side code, we require server side technologies here. So in that regard, here, if you're talking about this server side technologies, you know these languages, some of the famous languages. So like, you know, if you know either Java or something like a .NET or one of the most popular languages nowadays, that is backend language, that is node technology, or even nowadays people are using something like in Python also as a backend, we call it as a backend or server side technology. Okay. Using these, any one of them is required, not all, any one of them is fine here. So this is called backend here. These two layers together is called backend here. Or server. Why we call backend? Because if you're talking about your application, what kind of, you know, server side code you are using and what kind of code you have written with respect to your application cannot be seen by the user. Okay, fine. Yeah. Now, this is called presentation layer, where people can see, like, you know, your user, home page or login page, sign up page, all these things. Right? That's why we call it as something like front end. And this one we call it as front end. This is front end. So this has one more name also here, that is front end. Like other than front end, we call it as something like UI here. UI means user interface. Well, because this is the medium or through which a user can connect to our entire application, right? Through this presentation layer only, you'll be connecting to the entire application. That's the reason we can call it as even user interface as well. So using which you'll be able to, you know, interact with our entire application by logging or by doing some sign up activity and all. Right? So that's why we call it as a UI here. Okay, assume like, you know, in this UI, what you'll be having different pages, right? Assume you have something like some sign up pages there, somewhere else here, some sign up page is there. Then what will be there in that sign up page? You'll be having certain fields over there, like, you know, username or something like, okay, a sign up activity, right? First name, last name, and password, email ID, phone number, like that, different fields might be over there. And then you'll be having, you might be having a button like, you know, register here or something like sign up. The moment you click that button called, you know, sign up button, then what happens here is the data, whatever you are entering, will be transferred from your presentation layer, that is from your browser level, to the server side. The data will be transferred over the internet, it will be transferred. So that's the reason we are connected through internet to our whatever that remote server is set, to that it will be connected. So in this case, if you take Gmail as an example, gmail.com, www.gmail.com, that is, you know, just a domain name. Outside we can able to see, but at the back end, that is a server, what I can say, IP address for one server. It might be having something 192 point something else might be there, and that will be connected through internet, right? Okay, the data will be transferred from this presentation layer, from your browser level, to the data will go to server side. As I told you already, in this server side, there are some dedicated modules are there to deal with what I can say, like, in different activities. For example, now the activity is what? Sign up activity, right? That is registration activity, which you will do for today. Tomorrow you don't do the same. Tomorrow what you'll be doing? You'll be simply going with something like, you know, what I can say, only login you'll be doing. You don't do sign up again. Okay, assume this, the first one is like, you know, this is there something, right? This is a module which is responsible for a sign up activity. Then what it will do is, it will be actually, you know, connected to the database here. internal, it will be connected to the database here. And so inside that database, through this, in this module, what will be there? Some code will be there. It will call that database, and inside that database, you can have something like, you know, what I can say, like some table, some table kind of structure where users' data will be stored, right? So then it will be calling that table or something like that, where your user data will be stored in that. So that will be done. So that is happened with the help of this particular module. Right. Assume this is what happened, and you have written some code with respect to Java or something else happened. Okay, fine. Next case, that is like, you know, next day you wanted to do something like some login. You don't need to register again and again, right? So then what you'll be doing? You'll be doing something like, you know, a login activity. So assume like the there is one more page here, and where you're doing a login activity in which you'll be entering username, that is your mail ID or something, whatever it might be, the username which we set, and then the password for that account, and then you'll be having a button called, you know, proceed or something like login or submit, whatever it may be, some button will be there. So the moment you click login, then what happens? Again, same story, the data whatever you're entering, username and password, will be transferred from this presentation layer to this business layer. And here, in this, as we already discussed here, one module is for one activity, right? Assume this is a module which is for login related activity. Then this one will be calling the database now with your username. Whatever the username you're having, with that username, it will be calling the database, and from the database, it will get the data of that particular username. For example, the username is something like, you know, Ajay, assume some Ajay. The password is something like 1234, which we yesterday created. You know, assume like, you know, yesterday we created something like some sign up and everything done with the name called Ajay, username, and some password called some 1234. And today you're trying to log in now. So the moment you're typing it, then what happens, you know, the data, whatever you are entering with that username, all the data will be there, right? Mail ID, password, everything, the data will be, you know, you can able to retrieve, and you can check whatever the password and username entered is correct or not with the original password. You understand, right? So that comparison can be done. If it is true, like, you know, he has entered the proper username and proper password, then a home page will be returned to the user, that is to his browser, whatever the person is using that browser. In that browser, in that website, there you can able to see some home page or dashboard page. That is the case if he enters correct username or correct password combination. Assume he entered some wrong password combination, then an error message will be displayed in the same login page, right? So this is what happens. And this one is called, whatever it is happening from server side to, you know, your website level or presentation layer or your front end, is called response here. Whatever it is sent from your server level to, that is called, you know, response here. And whatever we usually send from here to here, this is called request here, from your website or from your presentation layer to the server side, whatever the things we sent are called request here. The request could be in the form of some data, the way we do in, you know, like sign up or login, or sometimes the request could be in the form of some simple clicking, or sometimes the request could be in the form of some, you know, link clicking or some button clicking. It could be anything. Assume like, you know, another example where assume you already log in and you're done with the logging activity, and you're having your dashboard page like email, okay, like Gmail kind of thing, where what you can do over there, assume like, you know, there will be something like inbox, something like different you know, things will be there. The moment you click that inbox, then what happens? So inbox related information will be open. That's it. Something, the moment if you click something like sent items, then something sent items related things will be opening. Not only that, if you open like some Facebook related application where there might be some like, you know, like symbol will be there. The moment you click it, what happens? So immediately it will go to the server side and that like activity will be finished. Like so many activities will be happening. That is like, you know, clicking or clicking a link or clicking a button or everything could be considered as a request. So in this web world, everything will be happening, you know, as a cycle of request as and response here. That only will be there if you're talking about any kind of application, whether it could be a commercial application or non-commercial application, or it could be, you know, anything. This is the one, request and response cycle would be there. But okay, fine, this is the way our web application works. Okay, fine. But where are, you know, React or React.js is going to come into picture? So that is what we are going to see now. So let me give you some introduction about that particular, what exactly, you know, React and all. So just we'll be finishing this in 2 minutes so that we can get into that. So here, when I'm talking about the server side code or server side software, this is actually code means server side software. This can be developed through either Java or .NET or Node.js or Python code. Fine. When you're talking about the database here, you can use any kind of database here, like a NoSQL style database like MongoDB and kind of things you can use, or you can go with another style like an SQL style, that is a DBMS style, like traditional databases like Oracle database or something like MySQL database, or you can use a SQL server or any database you can able to use them. That's not a big thing. But when you're talking about this presentation here, I'm talking about, you know, sign up page, sign in page means someone has to create those pages, right? So all these pages together are called, you know, nothing but simple, that is a website here. All the web pages integrated together is nothing but a website here. So if we can develop web pages so that you can easily develop the website here. So to develop this website, one must require knowledge in three different technologies here. Those are HTML and CSS and JavaScript. So here I'm using the word and here. When I'm talking about my server side, here I told either Java or .NET or Node or Python. But when it comes to this front end side, I can say this website or front end or UI side, I'm telling HTML and CSS and JavaScript. So we'll put three of them are required. Just a minute. So why we need three here? Definitely, if you are using three technologies, means each one of them might be having its own importance in website development. Definitely here. So when I'm talking about this HTML, whenever we talk about any web page, what a web page will be having, certain content will be there in the web page. For example, it will have some text related information, maybe some headings, some paragraphs, or some something, some different kind of text will be there. Or sometimes we do observe some buttons will be there, or sometimes some images will be there in the web page, right? Like that, some links will be there where people can click something on that. Like that, we have different kind of content will be there, right? So all such content to your web page can be added with the help of HTML here. So in another words, I can say, HTML is responsible for the content of your web page. So what content and a web page should contain can be added with the help of this HTML. All the kind of content can be added only through HTML. Okay, fine. Assume like, you know, I've decided to have some content like, you know, dear students, welcome to React. only that two lines I want in my web page. I don't want anything. I want only one web page in my website, and that too in that one web page I want simply, you know, dear students, welcome to React course, something like that I want. And then fine, but that dear students welcome to React, are the dear students should be in what color? That welcome to React course should be in what color? You understood that? Or that you know, dear students should be in what style? That is like, you know, you'll be having different styles of you know, text, right? What kind of style the text should be having? Or that should be with, you know, some normal text, or it should be bold, or it should be represented on the left side of your page, or it should be on the right side, rightmost side, or it should be in the center, that is middle of the page, or whatever it is. These are some different kind of, you know, stylings, I can say. So these stylings can be added with the help of here CSS here. So whereas CSS is responsible for the content of your responsible for not content appearance of your web page, whereas HTML is content responsible for content, whereas CSS is appearance. Okay, fine. But using these two, definitely we can work, right? Definitely we can create whatever the content we want to add. Yes, in HTML you have different tags. HTML will use something like tags. With the help of that tags, you can add any kind of content. When you're talking about CSS, with the help of some CSS properties will be there, like color for some text color, like background color for adding some background color. Like that, we do have different CSS properties to apply different styles to our web page. Okay, fine. Using these two, definitely we can able to create the web pages as well as anyhow, if you're creating web pages, please, definitely we can able to create the website also with the help of this pure HTML and CSS. But the problem with this is using these two or using HTML, we can only develop something like, you know, a static pages or static websites we can able to develop with the help of this. So I hope you people know what exactly the meaning of static here. Like whatever it's been written over there from the website admins, whoever is the owner of that website, whatever he has written, that can be read, that's it, by the user. User will not be interacting with your application much. That is about, you know, your static application is about. But if you add something like, you know, a JavaScript to your HTML, then what happens, you know, it will be creating a dynamic web page. Or in other words, I can say JavaScript is used to add some dynamic nature to our web pages here. Using JavaScript, by adding JavaScript to HTML, we can create some dynamic pages as well as which eventually dynamic websites here. And that is the reason here JavaScript decides the behavior of your web page. You know, that is like, you know, if users select something at that moment, some kind of content will be generated. How can I explain you, like, you know, dynamic nature? Yeah, with some simple example I can explain you. Like, assume there is one portal or one site is there in which you're having like, you know, bus booking site. You can book a bus. Okay, assume there, assume you have something like from and some Hyderabad, something like here you're having something like, you know, two. Assume like this is two, left side is like, you know, from field, and this is two field. In this you're having something like some Hyderabad, and to the in the two you're having something like Chennai. Okay, then here you'll be having some button called go. The moment you click here Hyderabad is selected, and Chennai is selected, and then go. The moment you click that button, just to below to that here one table will be generated, like, you know, where a list of buses will be there. Okay, and in that you'll be having a bus name, that is like, you know, travel's name, and then first serial number, and then travel's name, and then timing, like the number of seats, like that, assume fare or something like that will be there. Like that, assume total 20 buses, list of 20 buses has been there. Now the moment user changes this, what I can say, from Chennai to two position from Chennai to Bangalore, and then if you click go, then what happens immediately, the same in the same area called, you know, bus list area, same, but again that entire list will be gone and new one will be published over there with, assume, like, you know, some 30 buses are there now. The entire things will be changed. So that is what I am telling. So if you use normal HTML, you can use either only 20 buses, you can keep 20 buses here, or you can keep a list of 30 buses only. You cannot do that, is like, you know, dynamic. Whenever users select one option, as per that, the content has to be changed. So these kind of things cannot be achieved alone with the help of HTML. That is called, you know, your dynamic nature is about. So that's the reason here JavaScript is responsible for, you know, the behavior of your web page, how your web page has to behave as per user selections on the page, or as per user, you know, what I can say, activities on the page, how your page should respond, how it has to behave. That is what will be decided with the help of JavaScript. Okay, fine. Again, how React and where React? Okay, with the HTML, if you're talking, simply using tags. If you learn tags, HTML is done. That's it. Nothing else will be there. Like, you know, for paragraph, you have some T tag. For headings, you have something H1, H2, H3 kind of thing. Some images, you have some IMG tag. Like that, some tags will be there. Next to CSS, HTML is tag-based language. CSS is a property-based language where to add some color, some property will be there. To add some margin, some margin, you have some property will be there. So if you learn those property names, that is fine. But when you're talking about JavaScript, the actual programming will be there. So to add such a dynamic nature, first you'll be learning a JavaScript, and then you'll be adding the JavaScript to your page to impart that dynamic nature. In this, you'll be having variables, conditions, loops, functions, and different some events and different kind of things will be there in the JavaScript. And using that, yes, you can able to develop this. Okay, fine. Now you know the backend languages. Yes, you can do this, and you now you have HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Now you can develop the front end as well as backend. Both will be clubbed together, and so that, you know, your entire web application can be developed. But yeah, when we are talking about this server side also, there are certain things will be there. I think you might heard these things, like something like Spring, certain words like, you know, something like Spring, and something like Django, people call this Django or Django, or something like some Express, or something like some .NET Core. These things are called frameworks, guys. Here. So what we call them is called a frameworks. So frameworks are, we have to be very clear about this thing. Frameworks are not new technologies or something like new languages. They are not new programming language. They are not at all programming language, but they are developed on the top of some programming language, and which are used for the purpose of helping the programmer in his like, you know, development journey, whatever it might be. For example, if you are using something like Java, you want to develop some enterprise application, a big scale or something like medium scale enterprise application, you want to develop with the help of Java technology. So at that time, what happens, you know, if you're developing it using normal Java, it may take some more time or something like that and all. But if you're using something like Spring, what happens, you know, it will make your work easy. So nowadays, without framework, the actual development is not going to happen in the industry. So the same is the case with Python. If you're talking about Python web development, then people will use something like Django. People will be using something like Django here. And with the help of that, people can develop. In the same case, if you're talking about Node, you'll be having something like Express here as a framework here. With the help of that, we can do the development related activity. In the same way here, when you are talking about front end side, as I told you already, HTML is simple language. no much of code will be there. CSS is also same simple property names, but when you're talking about JS, the main logic or code will be written, right? So for this as well, if you want to create some powerful UIs or beautiful front ends and with more responsive nature and all such kind of what I can say, like web pages and websites, if you want to develop, then for this JavaScript as well, we can have certain frameworks on front end side as well. So there are so many frameworks are available, but among them, React is one of the most famous one. So React.js we have, other than React.js, we do have something like one more also that is also good, but that is like something like Angular. Something like this, and something like some backbone JS, like that. We have some other different things also available over there. React JS, Angular, etc. Different things over there. So in this, React JS is the one which we are going to learn. Actually, React JS is not exactly like a framework here, which is something more than the framework. It is like a library for your JavaScript related activities. It will be acting as a library over there. All the activities, whatever you want to do with the normal JavaScript, can be achieved with the help of this React.js in a more proper way and more quick and more, what I can say, responsive way. When you're talking about response in terms of code and that also will be quick. So, okay, but as it is having certain extra features, it can be termed even as something like a framework. That is what, your React.js is about. What exactly the React.js is? React.js is nothing but it's a, almost a privilege of, it is having a privilege of a framework, but it's a powerful library to develop JavaScript programming or JavaScript related activities at the front end side or UI. So that is about your React is. What exactly the React is. Now, I would like to talk a little. Just now, we are done with what is a web application, right? And then in that web application, what is backend we have seen, and what is frontend we have seen. In backend, how to develop the server side programming we have seen. And now we have seen what is presentation layer, that is UI. How to develop them, what is that is called a website, right? How to create a website, that is also we have seen different technologies, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and what are the roles of these different technologies also we have seen. And now we have seen why React also we have seen. What is React also we have seen. Now we are going to learn a little bit about React now. So when this React is came into picture, and what are the things associated with this React, a little bit of more introduction about React we are going to learn now. Okay, guys, just a minute. You please drop your details to Visual Path admin chat in a private chat. You people can share your details, guys. All of you, just Visual Path admin is the right organizer. Visual Path admin. To that, just in the chat box, use private chat and you just share your details. That is both your mail ID as well as your phone number. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I hope you are able to see this. Yeah. One of you just give me confirmation like you are able to see something like React and its logo. Just give me some confirmation so that I can go ahead.
Yes, we can.
Okay, thank you. Okay, as we discussed this, you know, this React is a UI related library, and it is used to build some single page applications here. So what exactly the meaning of single page application here is, when we are talking about web applications, which we usually see without any like React or something, if you don't use them, there are different pages will be there. For example, about us on one web page will be there, for contact one page will be there, services one page will be there, like the different HTML pages. You talk about HTML pages, different web pages will be there in a website. But when you're talking about single page applications for the entire web website, you'll be having only a single HTML page. Then you may get a doubt, like, you know, how I'm going to get my contact related information, how am I going to get some homepage related information, how I am going to get some services related information. Okay, don't worry, that we are going to learn in 2 minutes. Okay, but what exactly a single page application means, for your entire website you'll be maintaining one HTML kind of page, that is like, you know, a single page application you support. The main HTML page will be only one, and the opposite one to these applications are multi-page applications. Okay, fine. Now, it's an open source front-end JavaScript library. React is an open source. Anybody can use it without any, you know, having problem. You don't require any mandatory license or something. You don't need to purchase any license or something to use this. And it's developed by a team. Actually, not a team, but first one person started, and then later a team is formed at Facebook, and they developed some features in the React, and it's maintained by Facebook. So if you are talking about some history of that React here, as I told you, one person, right? So Jordan Walker, he created actually a React. Actually, you know, the purpose of creating React is not for, you know, like we have seen this, like, you know, JavaScript related framework and to develop some beautiful UIs and all. No, earlier his purpose is same UI only, but that is very limited one. And he usually, even he did not call it as a React. He made something like some faxes and for some other purpose. You know, in the Facebook, you'll be having some news feed, right? A new, everyday new news feed will be generated on the wall of a user. If you log in there, on your wall, you can able to see some news feed, right? So just to maintain that news feed with some new features, people use this React. Yeah, okay. So it is developed initially for this one, and later, you know, slowly they implemented in some of their other products, like, you know, in 2012, and they introduced this into their another product called, you know, Instagram. And then later they made it as a open source and people can use, that is like, you know, out of Facebook organization, other people also can use it. So that is like, you know, they made it open source. In next year they made it open source. So from then the React development has been started, but after 2-3 years of that, like around 15 or something like that, 16 and that. From then the usage of React has been predominantly increased, I can say. Earlier also that, but why exactly React? Okay, we can develop normally using JavaScript. Yes, we can do. JavaScript is a powerful language which can be used at front end, and JavaScript can have the ability to use it back end as well. Node.js is also nothing but JavaScript. JavaScript is one of the beautiful languages. But why to go with React? Means definitely there might be some features which enables us to incline towards React. So what are they? Why and that? So definitely the faster development process. If you're talking about a normal JavaScript environment, the way you do development and all, so definitely it will be more faster, and it has its rich, its own set of library will be there where so many things can be done that I cannot tell you directly, you know, theoretical, as a part of a theoretical session, I can't tell what exactly the library is, but so many things will be there. And the maintainability also is simple. If you're talking about the normal JavaScript writing code, one by one, just like that, instead of writing that, if you write using React and all, things will be like, you know, some better modularity will be there in your code, and maintainability also will be simple and easy. And efficient data binding can be achieved in React. And one of the important and beautiful concepts here is that it is a cross-platform development. The way you develop a React applications, these applications, if you develop, assume like, you know, and when I'm talking about this cross-platform, that is OS, assume, if you develop this in one particular OS called Windows and all, then once that entire application is ready, the same can be run without doing any modification. In Linux machine, you can run, or in the Mac machine, like, you know, Apple computers is able to run them with respect to you know, OS. I'm talking cross platform. When you're talking about the browser also, it supports cross browser platform support as well. That is like, in the moment if you develop any React application in your computer, assume that you developed it and you tested it in some, like, you know, assume like some Chrome or somewhere else, yes, it is working fine, then definitely the same thing can be work in the same way in Firefox or some Safari or some Opera or some other browsers as well. So that is what, you know, cross platform development is about. And by default, it is an SEO friendly, like, you know, for your websites and for your web applications and for your front ends, for your website, whatever you develop, doing of SEO also a bit easy compared to normal websites. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. It will be having a more speed and in terms of response, even the performance also definitely fine with respect to normal jobs. And it's more declarative in nature. And if I want to talk about much about, you know, declarative, so here I can talk when we are learning React, and there you can tell what exactly, you know, declarative. In simple words, I can say, like, it's not about writing much of the code. Instead of that, you know, we'll be declaring something and that will be doing some activity. That is about it. And it will be having its own developer tools. Like, you know, so many tools are available for debugging related activities about your React. Then learning the React here. So that is a simple one. As it is pure JavaScript related thing, right? Your learning curve also will be easy, because here our focus will be more on, you know, front end based. That is UI focused. The design will be more on, like, you know, UI focus, not much on, like, you know, your application server side and all. We don't think much about it. So we'll be concentrating on UI, right? The design will be more of UI focus, and it's easy to adapt as it is, like, you know, a pure JavaScript related thing. Yeah. So I talked about single page application, right? So now I will tell what exactly, you know, single page application, so that you can easily understand. So this particular React follows component driven architecture or component based architecture. That is, if you're talking about the multi-page application where different pages will be having for different content, like, you know, for contact related, you have some contact.html, for about.html, some services.html, assume the client, some clients.html, for home.html, examples, okay, for different pricing, some pricing.html, you'll be having different pages. But if you're talking about single page, how that can be achieved here is your entire web page usually be divided into different components. That's it. And what data can be displayed in that component, that is controlled, or that is written in your JavaScript code, that is in your React code that will be written. That's it. But your page, if you're talking only one page, if you look at this, you can get. So assume, you know, this is your entire page, okay? And there, what I'm having here, something like header component, something footer component, and some menu component on the left side of that one, and some search component, example. or something like contactor component, some display component. So here my display component is something which might be a dynamic one or which might be a volatile one, can be changed immediately according to, as per search. If somebody search something in the search box, search component, and if you click some button, and immediately that data present in that display component could be changed, or in my menu component, I will be having certain menus, like in certain links will be there. If I click one button, one kind of content may be displayed in my display component. If I click other button, then other kind of content may be displayed in my display component. You understand that? So in this way, the entire application is divided into different components instead of different pages. You understood my point, right? That is what, your component architecture is about. At the same time, that is what a single page application is about. And using React, we will be developing single page applications. Yeah, so this is about your component architecture and all. So if you use components, definitely it's a huge advantage. Why? Because you can divide your entire application into different components, right? And whenever there is some problem and all, you can easily detect, in that component the problem is occurring and all, what could be the remedy and all. So debugging also will be easy, and even the maintainability also will be easy. So actually, you may think like more components, more complexity. No. So if your application is big and huge, if you're using some more components, it improves your maintainability. More components, more flexibility of your code. So there are certain things which are important with respect to your React here. That is something like some JSX. Okay, don't worry about what exactly JSX and that. Some virtual term and some that is like rendering the data. I will just talk about virtual DOM. Virtual DOM is nothing but document object model. Whatever the web page you generally create, and you where we'll be executing our web page, definitely in the browser, on the browser, on any of the browser. Then a DOM will be created at the back end. That is like document object model. Like, assume like four paragraphs are there in your page and four headings are there. But we think like, they are tags, but how browser thinks like, that is like, in terms of some objects it will think. So if you're talking about dynamic, the moment you are using, by using that JavaScript, if you click some button and all, that data will be changed over there. Something like some data can be changed. That is called DOM manipulation. So when that DOM is changed, then only we can able to see some changes in the runtime. You understood that? DOM, document object model, that is nothing but your page only. In other words, your page will be changing as per user selections in the JavaScript environment. Okay, it will be done. But in other frameworks or even normal JavaScript and all, what happens, the entire DOM will be taken into consideration. And if some changes are happening, the entire DOM will be reflected with that changes, or I can say that the entire DOM will be updated with that changes. So when you're talking about this virtual DOM concept, what exactly React will do is, at the back end, the original DOM will be there, and a copy of that DOM will be generated for this React, through this React. And whatever the change you want to do in that DOM, assume like total 20 components are there, and the change you are doing is only three elements. Total 20 elements are there, in that only three elements you are doing the change. So in other case, if you don't use React, what happens, normal DOM or real DOM, then other cases, the entire you'll be doing the change only in three elements, but the entire DOM will get affected, or it will be reloaded, I can say. But when you're talking about this virtual DOM concept, the entire copy of the DOM will be taken out, and only those three elements will be updated. Only those three elements will be updated, and that will be again copied into your original DOM. So with this, what happens, if I talk like this, then you may not feel much difference. But when you're talking about the real-time application, that too with the heavyweight applications, and there, you can see the speed here. So the response, and definitely, right? So 20 elements again, loading and reloading. unnecessary, right? So, but if you're using this virtual DOM concept, that next rendering is nothing but how you're representing the data, how you're publishing the data in the pages, that is rendering. Next, how you'll be generating the components, and inside that you'll be having some states and that. Okay, I don't want to talk much about them, what exactly that is. We'll be discussing about them in detail when we are talking about it, especially this React. Next class, we've been able to talk about this. So here, we'll be having some other important things like, you know, props, we call them, and you know, forms also, how to generate forms. Normally, forms will be available, but in React, how we'll be working with that one. And how we are able to navigate from, you know, one component, I can say pages, but you know, using React, we'll be developing the single page applications. No? So that's why from one page to other page, how to navigate. Instead of that, I can call it one component to other component, how we are going to navigate and how we can able to import some stylings here. Now, with respect to using React as well, we can provide certain stylings. So other than that, still we have some more additional concepts which we do learn in React. They are something like some list and keys and some filters, some React hooks, one of the important concepts of React here, some context API, what exactly, some Redux to store management, what is that one? And at the end, connecting our React, our front-end application with the APIs. The APIs is nothing but, you know, your back-end application. API is nothing but your back-end. Just now we have seen, right, front-end and back-end one. Yeah, so this is about, you know, your normal React is about. Okay, and just a minute. Yeah, if you look at this, here, you know, back-end, and this, once you generated from this back-end API can be connected to the front-end here. Okay, so in the React, after learning all the concepts in React and developing some UIs, front-ends using React, after completion of that, we will be learning how to connect our front-end application with the back-end API. That is either back-end API might have been generated either using Java language or Node or Python, we don't worry about it. Why? Because, you know, that is already a ready-made application, and that's how we are going to integrate with our you know, front-end application. That is what, you know, connecting your React application or React front-end with the back-end API. So that part also we will be learning. Clear? So now with this, we are finished with what exactly, you know, web application development is about, and what are the different types it will be having, and in that what is website development, in that what is the role of HTML, CSS, as well as JavaScript, and there what is front end and what is back end, and then what is React, and then later why React, what are the main concepts of the React and all that. So now here I just would like to discuss about one simple aspect that is, like, you know, I developed one simple React-related application here. I just would like to, what I can say is, execute this one, okay? This will take a minute. I want you to just observe this, okay? Don't worry about the commands, whatever I use, don't worry about all these things, okay? Just observe how it is working, that's it. It may take two more seconds to start. Just be patient. This is a simple application, nothing much there. Just for your demo purpose, I just created a simple sample application here. Yeah. Meanwhile, Nikhil, could you please drop your details, your mail ID as well as phone number to VisualPath admin? Or VisualPath also, no problem. Either VisualPath or VisualPath admin, we just drop your details in that private chat. Nikhil, I hope you are able to hear me.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you please drop your details. Here something is happening. This is only open the browser, and if you look at this, it is telling that something, some development server is started. So I developed it long time ago. Yeah, now it is working. It's working on localhost 3000, and yeah, if you look at this, yeah, this is a simple application where you are able to see something is spinning over there, and some color background is there. Yeah, some name by default, some name is there, and here I'm writing some other name, something like some Ajay, and now I'm clicking something, but yes, it's working, something is happening, but nothing is getting reflected or something like that. I'm clicking, nothing is happening. Why? Because this is my front end. This is my React, and where instead of, you know, different sign up or something different, what I can say, like fields, I'm having only one field. I'm just using something like button called go. Nothing is happening here, but because the data is not getting transferred to my server, or I don't have a server is running over there. My server is not running. My backend is not running, so nothing is getting happening over there. So, but you know what I want to do here is something here. I would like to run my backend now. So this, if I click this one, nothing is happening, right? So now, if I do something like some simple change here, not change, just backend running. So here, if I click something, assume just observe, nothing is getting happening, right? So now, what I am going to do here is I am going to run my backend now. So in this first React app only, I'm having something like, you know, server.js one file is there, and that I would like to run now. So I don't know the file name is server.js or some other name I gave. Okay, inside the server. So inside that one, inside the server, I'm having that name. Okay, index.js. So inside that server folder, I'm having index.js. So let's go to server. And so now I'm running my backend. So the backend can be written in any language, right? So my backend is written in Node language. So now I am running the backend one. Okay, that is running Express is the one, you know. I told you, right? Express is a framework used for Node, the way you use Spring for Java. Okay, that is running on some other port. Fine. This is not a big deal. The thing is this one. So here, this is the earlier one, right? So the moment we click, nothing has got happened, right? So now you observe this guy. Something is happening. It is telling, like, you know, welcome Ajay. So this welcome Ajay is the response which is coming from my server to the over page. This is what I'm talking, this response I'm talking, guys. Got it, right? So this is happening from server side to the, you know, front end said this is happened, this response has happened. Some message, whatever you are sending, actually these two things are there. Whatever you are sending from your as a request, whatever you are sending from your front end React to the server side, Node server, that data has been transferred, and the same data, taking that data again, some information is extra added, and that is sent back. You understand? You change this something else. Then that can be there. Now click this. Welcome, right? So this is about, you know, how your application is going to work and clear. So that's it, guys. That's it from my side for today's demo session or interactive session or whatever it is, first session or you name whatever it is. But this is about, you know, what exactly React is and why we have to learn React and how React is going to work. Okay. So that's it from my side. And any queries you are having, then if you have any queries, and I am open to your questions, guys. So you can ask me questions by unmuting yourself. You can ask your doubts or questions, or even, you know, you can shoot out your questions in the chat boxes. And coming to the sessions, guys, all the sessions will be interactive sessions, and more of practical oriented sessions will be there. Everything will be practical oriented sessions, and as it is a online mode, instructor led everyday live session will be there, right? And once the session is finished and your session will be recorded, guys, and by chance if you have missed any of the session during the course, no problem, you can able to listen to that particular session. Not only that particular session, the entire program, like in your entire ReactJS program, whatever it is being conducted by me, so all the sessions will be stored and will be recorded and stored. And for that portal, you'll be given access, so that even though you miss a class once or twice, and it won't be a problem for you to have that continuity, as well as even later also, once the sessions are finished and later as well, you can able to go through that those sessions and here. So that is about your mode of training and all. The course will last for 30 hours. Can you show me your back end?
We have daily classes or daily sessions or only weekends?
No, we don't have daily sessions. Daily sessions will be there now.
What could be the timings?
Yeah, that will be before 9:30. The session
before 9:30.
Yeah.
Okay.
Office time is, yeah.
Okay. Including weekends also?
Yeah, mostly weekends won't be there, but sometimes specifically if required, then it will be there. That will let you know. If one weekend, if I want to take, then I will let you know.
Okay.
Yeah. Any other doubts, Naveen?
No. So before coming to this ReactJS, I have an idea on HTML, CSS, but JavaScript, I don't have that much idea.
Okay.
So parallelly, can I learn that also, or is it difficult to me?
No. You can learn. Parallelly, you can learn. No problem.
Okay. Currently, I'm working on other.
Yeah, before starting my JavaScript as well, before starting my React sessions as well, some important concepts on JavaScript, I will give you some glance. I can't say it's a session on all JavaScript concepts, but some glance I can give you.
Okay.
No problem.
And parallel, okay. Okay. While you're telling that introduction, could you tell what are the main topics we have to concentrate on JavaScript? Could you say that?
You are from? Your background is from?
Presently, I am working on SAP, yeah.
Okay.
Do you have
any programming language experience so far?
Yes, but it is not, it is SAP ABAP.
Okay, ABAP is like some Java kind of thing on the right.
No, it is completely different from Java.
Yeah, that is okay. That the purpose is different, everything is different, but why I use that word Java? Because some development, as in like some.
Yeah.
See, in SAP, HANA, FICO, that is different. No? ABAP,
correct.
I heard that something like, okay, development.
They
are completely different. No? That's right, yeah. I felt it is something related. That's why I use the word Java. Okay, fine. No problem. When you're talking about this JavaScript, simple. That is like, how variables will be declared and all. How conditions, simple. If and all, same conditions and some loops. Other than that, the important aspect is functions. That variables, conditions, loops, you can finish only just in one day. Just in 2 hours, you can finish all of it. But important thing is something like, some functions, what is functions and that, Then one important thing like JavaScript is that like something like events, and then something like some DOM. What is DOM and all? How to work with DOM and all?
Yeah,
that's it. If you can do these things in this variables only, you'll be having something like data types and all, some arrays and all different things. So you do that, that if you can do these things, that is enough.
Okay. Daily 1 hour session or 1.5 hours
session? It will be 1 hour, something like some little bit more than 1 hour, 1 hour 15 minutes, like not 1.5 hours.
Okay.
Currently, yeah.
Okay.
Any other doubts, Navin?
Not now.
Okay.
Thank you.
So the timings I told you, right? It will be like, you know, I'm having in my mind keeping like, you know, working professionals. It will be before 9:30. Before 9:30, it will be finished. 9:30.
Before 9:30, it will be finished, or?
No, yeah, it will be finished. AM.
So means yeah. we will start at 8 or 8:15,
like,
right?
Like that. Yeah, like.
Yeah, okay, that will be good.
Yeah.
Okay,
thank you. Yeah, okay. Nikhil, yeah, if you don't have any doubt, just let me know in the chat box, like, you know, you're clear, so that, you know, we can move ahead. You have to put from your end is like, you know, two things, some time and some practice. That's
yes, probably. Yes, sir.
You can easily learn. So React is one of the most popular frameworks nowadays. Yeah, most popular. In UI era, UI, what I can say, UI environment, it's React era is different. Once when that React has got more popular, so it's like React is like doing anything nowadays, I can say, in the UI part. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Any other doubts regarding session? I hope you got the point, right? What exactly? Why? What?
Yes, sir. I have made the website in React, static website.
Your?
Static website I have made in React.
Okay.
I know knowledge about backend of in React, how it's work. Thank you for that. You had to tell me that. So how this working? Of React and Redux.
Okay, so in our general, that is what, you know, first we'll be starting with the basics of React and all, how different elements in the React are going to work, that we'll be learning. And once that is done, and later some React hooks and how we are going to use them, and props and state management. Once that is done, on UI development we'll do with React, and then backends will be there. How to connect your backend APIs into your React application? How we are going to consume the data which is coming from the backend, and how we are going to display in our React pages and all that. We'll be learning everything. We'll be learning.
Yeah, okay. So.
Clear?
Yes. Yes. Thank you.
Okay, Nikhil, then we'll be winding up now. Okay.
Okay.
Looking forward to meet you guys soon in the classroom. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you. Bye.